One of the scariest things that a person could go through is being stalked. Having somebody following you everywhere you go, sneaking into your home, following you to your work. How many of you out there have dealt with stalkers? Pretty scary. I had some situations a few years back where every night this car would park in front of my house, and I would get up to go to work at 3 o'clock in the morning, and I would come out of my, this is in another town that I was living in, I would walk out through the side of the door and this car would come in through my alley, and they'd go really slow and drive by me. But I never found out who it was, and it only happened about a month or so, and eventually it stopped. I still don't know what that was all about, but pretty creepy situation. But let's talk about this 8 insanely creepy real life stalker stories. Let's check this out.
Snail Bros presents the 8 most terrifying stalkers ever. Number 1. Among the most infamous stalkers in recent times has been Robert John Bardo. Even prior to his last target, he was known for stalking celebrities. Bardo set his sights on a young star of the sitcom My Sister Sam in 1986. He didn't keep his obsession a secret. He even employed a private investigator who provided Bardo with Rebecca Schaefer's home address 3 years after he zeroed in on the star. Initially approaching Rebecca for an autograph, she obliged politely. When he came back later, however, she infuriated him by asking him to leave. Instead, he shot her in the chest. Number 2. Men are not the only ones to develop dangerous obsessions, and celebrities are not always the target. Jamie Calloway originally met the object of her obsession, a corrections officer, while serving time in jail. After stalking her target, she was arrested again in 2012. Delusional and easily identified by the word God emblazoned on her forehead, Jamie believed the female officer was her lover. Calloway is awaiting trial for allegedly slashing the object of her obsession's tires, sending her packages, and calling her repeatedly. Number 3. No list of stalkers would be complete without John Hinckley Jr., who in 1980 followed Jodie Foster to Yale and enrolled in the university just to be close to her. John Jr. stalked his obsession by leaving her love notes and poems. Foster was attending the prestigious college during a sabbatical from acting. Somehow, Hinckley concluded that the only way to win Foster's love was to kill then-President Ronald Reagan. After leaving a note to that effect, Hinckley set off to D.C. on March the 30th, 1981, and proceeded to shoot Reagan and members of his staff before being captured. Hinckley has been treated since his capture as an inpatient in a psychiatric facility, after being deemed not guilty by reason of insanity. In recent years, he has been granted ever longer visits to his mother's home, up to 17 days at a time.
Wow, I did not know that.
Social media has provided another way for stalkers to gain access to their prey. Lua Placencia used Facebook as a way to get closer to his obsession, model Courtney Repair. Repair has received very violent messages from Placencia via both Facebook and email, including a wish for her to wreck her car and smash her face through the windshield. Because he also had the model's address, as well as friends and family members' names, the FBI became involved. Eventually, Placencia was traced to Chicago, where he was captured and is awaiting trial. Number 5. Sean Johnson is yet another celebrity to be stalked and harassed. Her stalker, Robert O'Ryan, drove from Florida to California to be closer to the Olympic gymnast. While driving cross-country isn't a crime, attempting to break into the Dancing with Stars set is. O'Ryan was arrested during his attempt to reach the star in 2009. After his arrest, police found love letters, duct tape, and loaded weapons in his car.
That gun collection.
O'Ryan's delusions included feeling that he was in telepathic communication with celebrities, including Sean, whom he claimed spoke to him while she performed at the Olympics. Number 6. Social media moguls are not immune to stalking. Pre-Deep Manukonda, was taken to court by the target of his obsession, Mark Zuckerberg. The founder of Facebook filed a restraining order against Munikonda in 2011. In the restraining order, Zuckerberg alleged that the stalker sent him handwritten letters and Facebook messages, was following him, and had threatened him. Zuckerberg's stalker also went after his family. His wife, who was his girlfriend at the time, and his sister were targeted. Munikonda was also allegedly seen both at Facebook headquarters and Zuckerberg's home. Number 7. Since even ordinary people are not immune to stalkers, it is no wonder that someone whose moniker is only one name garners attention from the obsessed as well. Madonna has had a slew of crazy fans.
Wow, he looks like a serial killer.
The most intimidating has to be Robert Dewey Hoskins, a psychotic homeless man. He is currently in a mental institution and has served time in prison. He has threatened Madonna on numerous occasions. He even once stated he was going to slit her throat. Before being committed to a mental institution, Hoskins was shot by one of Madonna's security guards after being found in her pool. He had climbed a fence to gain access to the property. Number 8. No claim to fame comes without a downside, as Laura Decker discovered. The 16-year-old set a world record in 2012 for sailing solo around the world.
Okay, I remember her.
She was stalked by a 60-year-old pedophile for more than a year. The pedophile, known as Gerard W., sent Decker emails and was in possession of child pornography, including a nude picture of Decker that he admitted was a fake. Gerard subsequently spent time in prison after turning himself in. Thank you for watching yet another amazing video.
Pretty,
please do subscribe.
Crazy people out there. But the crazy thing is, those people are actually kind of sane compared to some other people who are really unstable. But be safe. You just never know. There could be somebody stalking you right now and you don't have a clue. So I've ran into some pretty strange people in my life. And it's crazy. It really is.